In this example, we're going to practice working with the parametric equations of a circle. So here's the setup. Consider the parametric equations x equals 2 cosine of 3t, y equals 2 sine of 3t, for t's between 0 and 4 pi. And in part A, I want to graph the parametric curve indicating the orientation, and then describe the shape. So how do we go about graphing parametric curves in general? The way this is approached is just to simply make a table of values for various points in time, for various t points, and then just to graph those points on the xy plane. So let's start by approaching part A from that direction. So let's start with a t value of 0. That's the beginning of our interval. And to fill in this chart, I'm just going to be plugging in 0 to my different equations here. So here, for my x value, I'm going to get 2 cosine of 0. And then for my y value, I'm going to get 2 sine of 0. Well, 2 cosine of 0 is just going to give me 2 times 1, which is 2. And 2 sine of 0 is going to be 2 times 0. So 0. So then at time equals 0, I'm at this point 2, 0. And from here, I'm going to continue by simply filling in more time values or t values on my chart. And I'm not going to show all of those in detail, but I will figure out a few and plot them and write them here. All right, so I've started off our chart here, and I've done some values so far between 0 and pi. So let's go ahead and plot these and try to get a sense of what's going on here. So at time equals 0, I'm at the point 2, 0. So here I am right here. And then at pi equals 4, I'm at negative root 2, root 2. So root 2 is about 1.4. So I am somewhere around here, perhaps. And then at pi over 3, I'm at the point negative 2, 0. So I'm here. And then at the point pi over 2, I'm at the point 0, negative 2. So here. And then at 2 pi over 3, it looks like I'm back at the point 2, 0. Right, so I'm back at this point that I passed through before. And then at time pi, I'm at the point negative 2, 0. So now I'm back here at this point. So I don't really have that many dots here. So if you really didn't know the shape, if you had no sense at all what this was, you would probably need to plot a few more points. But from experience, I know that this is going to be a circle. So I'm going to go ahead then and connect these in a circular shape. And my circle's not great here, but this should be circular. And as far as the orientation, that's just going to depend on the way we plot the points as t increases. And in this case, that happens to be in the counterclockwise direction. So how did I know that this was going to be a circle? Circles have a certain form when you write them with parametric equations, and that form is the following. So the circle has a form, x equals h plus a cosine of omega t, and y equals k plus a sine of omega t. So here, the center of the circle is given by the point hk, and the radius is going to be the absolute value of a. We'll talk more about what omega means in just a second. So if you happen to know those equations well, then you could have known from the beginning what the shape would look like. So let's just take a second to describe the shape we see here. So what we see is a circle. With radius of 2 and a center at the origin. And we know that both from the graph that we drew by plotting points, but also we could have known that just by the original equation, right? I see this coefficient of 2 in front of the cosine and the sine. That tells me my radius is 2. And then I do not have any terms h and k being added out front. Okay, so that tells me that my center is at the origin. And now some other important facts about this circle is that it's traced out counterclockwise. And also, the circle is going to be traced out multiple times over our t interval from 0 to 4 pi, right? We only plotted from 0 to pi, and we had already started going back around the circle. So over this interval of 4 pi, we're going to traverse the circle multiple times. And we'll talk a little bit more about that in Part B. So in Part B, we're asked, how long does it take to complete one rotation around the circle? Okay, so in other words, what interval or what is the length of t that it takes to go once around the circle? So here we need to know a little bit more detail about these parametric equations of the circle. So we have this omega that we see here in both of these equations. H plus a cosine omega t, k plus a sine of omega t. Omega is what we call the angular frequency. Or we can think of that as the radians traced out per unit time. So here's a useful fact. It takes a t interval of length 2 pi over the absolute value of omega to trace out one full circle. And we could actually refer to this as the period of the rotation if we wanted to. So once we know that little fact, it's not hard to figure out the answer to Part B, how long does it take to complete one rotation around the circle. So in our case, if we look at our equations here, we see that omega is 3. So in our case, omega is 3. So my period, or the length of time it takes for one rotation, is going to be 2 pi over 3. And this actually makes sense based on what we saw when we were creating our table of values up here. We saw that at t equals 2 pi over 3, that was the first time we came back to our starting point, the point 2, 0. Now, if we wanted to, actually, we could, from this information, we could figure out how many times the circle is traced out on our interval from 0 to 4 pi. And to do that, we'd simply take 4 pi and just divide it by 2 pi over 3. So here that gives me 4 pi times 3 over 2 pi. So it looks like we just get 2 times 3, or 6 times. So the circle is traced out 6 times on the t interval from 0 to 4 pi. All right, so let's finish this out with Part C. In Part C, we're asked to eliminate the parameter t and write the equation of this curve in Cartesian form. So here's my original parametric equations again. So how do I go from these to a Cartesian representation of the curve? Well, if I know that I'm working with a circle, there's a pretty straightforward way to do this. We can look at x squared plus y squared. Okay, so I'm going to take this expression, 2 cosine of 3t squared plus, and then 2 sine of 3t squared, and let's work out what that is. So if I square 2 cosine of 3t, I'm going to get 4 cosine squared of 3t, and then plus 4 sine squared of 3t. And from here, I can factor out a 4 and be left with cosine squared of 3t plus sine squared of 3t. And then from there, I just have to know a really useful and important fact, a Pythagorean trig identity, that sine squared of x plus cosine squared of x equals 1. So here I have cosine squared of 3t plus sine squared of 3t. So that also equals 1. So I just get equals 4. So then what I've figured out then is that x squared plus y squared equals 4, which is the equation of a circle of radius 2 in Cartesian form. Now in this particular case, we know that parametrically the entire circle was traced out. So then I don't need to include any limitations here. I'm just going to include the full circle, x squared plus y squared equals 4. So this video is just meant to give you a little bit of a sense of how to work with these parametric circles. You'll have a chance to work through some more examples if you feel that you need to.